The next experiment is delta modulation and demodulation. Delta modulation is a kind of modulation in which each sample is sent with an information of either 1 or 0. To understand it, have a look at this particular diagram where XT is the message signal that has to be modulated into delta modulation, and the delta modulated digital binary data is shown here, which as you can see is digital 0111. The waveform, the step waveform that we see here is basically the demodulated delta modulation waveform, which is actually used for generating the delta waveform that we see here. How this is done is basically with the help of this demodulated step waveform, the circuit will decide if the current message signal is more than the demodulated value. If it is more than the demodulated value, then the next bit will also be 1. This being 1 means that the next demodulated step will again go up, but still it is not able to catch up with x of t. So again the next bit will be 1, which again makes the step go up. This will keep on happening until the step crosses over the signal x of t. Then the next bit will be 0, so the step will automatically come down. Thus, as you can see, the step waveform will in a way try to imitate x of t, which the demodulated wave of x of t, and this difference between x of t and its demodulation wave is basically encoded as a binary data of 1 and zeros. And this is the delta waveform that is being sent, pulses of zeros or ones. This is the circuit of delta modulation demodulation circuit. Here we have a comparator which is made out of IC324, an open IC. The comparison is between the message signal MT and the demodulated output MT bar. Now, the output of this comparator will be either high or low. If we are giving high to pin number 2, which is the pin of 7474 IC, which is actually a D flip-flop, as you can see here there are 2 D flip-flops out of which we are using 1, then we will basically get at the output 5 an extended value of whatever is coming in 2. But the clock here, which is connected to the preset and the clear pin, will make sure that at the output pin 5 we will keep on getting pulses with the frequency of this 2 kilohertz clock whenever pin 2 is high. Whenever pin 2 is low, we will get no output at pin 5, which means that it is a 0. This is the circuit for comparison part. As you can see, it compares the message signal and the demodulated signal. As shown here, whenever MT is greater than MT bar, the comparator output is high and we get consecutive ones. And whenever it is less than MT bar, then the comparator output is low, at which times we get all zeros. At times we may get slope overload because M bar T is not able to follow MT. This gives long list of ones. This will result in a demodulated wave which is not exactly following the input message signal. This needs to be avoided. Thus, to avoid the slope overload, what we do is we try to take care that the slope of MT is greater than the slope of the message signal. That means the slope of the demodulated output is greater than the slope of the message signal. Then we can avoid the slope overload problem. The slope of M bar T, which is the demodulated output, is decided by the VCC, which here is 5 volt, and the RC that we see here, which is used for basically demodulating the delta modulated output. It's a simple RC low pass filter which converts the signal back to its original form. This R and C are basically decided based on whatever is the slope of MT, which in our case is given by this equation, 2.5 into 2 pi f, where f is 200 hertz. That has to be substituted in the slope of MT, and this equation has to be substituted at the slope of m bar t. VCC is taken as 5 volt. C is assumed to be 0.01 microfarad, and thus we are able to design what is the value of R. So it will come that R has to be less than a certain value, from which we assume what is the value we should take for R so that slope overload error does not happen. So as you can see in this circuit, we can see both the modulation as well as the demodulation part in the transmitter circuit itself. The same circuit will be there for the demodulated circuit at the receiver end. Thank you.